and dog fouling. It's of their own making. And I'll tell you this, when I contacted Andrea, the dog warden, and asked her if she knew about this scheme of voluntary dog wardens, they knew nothing about it. So, you know, it's typical Rotherham Borough Council.
Firing up as we back onto the park. Yeah. I see them walking the dogs.
Do you see them dog fouling?
Sorry,
but I'll speak to you about that after Sandra, because I've been trying to get reports.
Are you proposing that we write to them?
I'm proposing that we write to Rotherham Borough. I will write to them on the council's behalf if you would like to, but it will be quite an insulting letter, I'll tell you now. Do you want me to write?
It does need to go through the council, but are you proposing that you would draft something for
yes.
the council to say?
Yes, I will. Yeah.
You can't be rude. With it coming from the council.
I won't be rude, but I will state the facts as I've stated them to the council. If there's anything that I've said to you lot, then say so now. If you don't want me to say it, but I will give them the facts. They've created this situation themselves, and they're trying to find a way out that looks good on paper, but hasn't got a hope in hell of working.
I was just going to raise a point, Christine. I mean, I'm a dog owner. Colin is. We take our animals for, like, possibly a sizeable majority of the community. One Saturday morning, I woke up to see hundreds of red circles painted all over the grass. Yeah. Complication is, that was possible. I won't say it's worse than the dog fouling. I think, obviously, something needs to be done, because there's nothing worse than, like, the green areas where kids will probably play or aim to play. People want to walk. You don't want to tread in somebody else's mess.
Well, there is the toxicaris angle of it as well, Paul.
I mean, looking at it, I mean, the honest answer is that I don't think, other than making the people of Anston that exercise their dogs in the community, that they have responsibility to other, not only dog owners, people with kiddies that possibly want to go on these green areas. Mm. There's nothing worse than...
You won't see it outside the schools, Paul. It's shocking. Well, they do it outside the school gate.
The problem is, I think it's a community issue where an irresponsible dog owner just lets his dog do whatever and just walks away. Even if you actually say something to them, it's not my job, it's the council's job, which it isn't. They need to be made aware the disease, the implications of doggy mess, be polite with it. I mean, yes, send a letter to the council, but I mean, judging by what's been said, I think it's the community's possible to do something rather than the council. I mean, obviously people aren't going to give the names, addresses, judging by what you've said. It's just an irresponsible, it's today's society, I suppose, that do not want to bear responsibility.
Do you know why the dog warden sprays the red paint, Paul?
She's run out of green paint, which the previous week.
It's to identify, hoping to shame the dog owners, to let people see it, but also to mark out so the street cleaners can clean up. But can I just tell you here and now, if you're in Street Pride, they will send the street cleaners out to clear up the mess. Unfortunately. Sorry?
On a park?
No, anywhere. Anywhere. But unfortunately, they've sacked some of them as well, so you've got to wait in the queue. And I am trying to get it over. I speak to members of the public about it.
So just to wrap the discussion up, unless anybody has any other points, the proposal is for Christine to draft a letter in reply to send.
No, can't do a nice one, Paul. If that's a condition, then I can't do it.
So you draft a nice one.
No, can't do a nice one.
To.
I will draft a factual letter.
If you don't feel able to draft a letter on behalf of the council,
you could
send a letter.
I already have, Stuart, thank you.
I wanted the council to send a letter.
I think as a council, we should point out that we're not going to do Rotherham Borough Council's job.
I'm all for that, but
you're
going to draft the letter.
Right. Would it be safer to leave it to you, Michael?
Well, my response, if it was just my response, would be to reply saying that this service should be the responsibility of the RMBC and should not be pushed onto parishes as a consequence of reduction in frontline staff?
I think that will do nicely. I've already replied to the dog warden manager and to this, what's his name. So, yeah.
All those in favour?
What? The thing. But if anybody does see any dog fouling, please, will you report it to Street Pride, try and get a description of the dog and the owner, and they will do the best to follow it up.
Thank you. So the next item is the Mayor's Charity Committee.
Yes, sir.
Any comments based on that? Oh, Stuart, do you mind if you put Colin in first, or are you going to want to go?
I'll say what we normally do with him. So what we normally do is receive the letter, and if individuals wish to make a donation, quite well.
We have missed.
That's what we normally do, but I'll second this.
I'll second, yeah. I'll go along with that.
My proposal is that not only do we accept the letter, but we take £50 from the chairman's allowance and send it to him.
Unfortunately, it's not.
Well, we agreed at the start of this council that the chairman wouldn't spend his £200 on fripperies.
Well, he can spend it in Anston.
Now, hang on, Chris. So I think a donation of £50 would not go amiss to the mayor's charity.
Just as a general thing, though, because this is finished this Easter.
Oh, yeah.
The Easter egg thing's actually finished now. It was last week. But we can.
That's why I said a check, not an egg.
If it's already going to finish, then I propose to just send the letter.
Unless you want to propose that we make a donation to the mayor's charity, you are proposing.
Yes, sorry,
so can we receive the letter and then you put that forward as a separate proposal?
Yeah.
So to receive the letter, it's proposed by Stuart, it's seconded by Paul. All those in favour of receiving it, then Colin would like to propose that we donate £50 to the mayor's charity.
Yes.
Okay. Does that have a second?
What out of
can I ask speak,
Jason?
Yes,
you can
call.
I disagree with Colin. We need a secondary.
Yeah, me too.
I'm a firm believer in challenging you to talk.
Me too.
Hang on.
Just shush a minute. Hang on. Not only that, but I forgot what I was going to say.
sorry, Rick, do you mind if I just...
You can't, because I forgot.
Do we have a second for Colin's proposal?
Yes.
Oh, we do. Okay. In that case, carry on.
Well, can I... Sorry. Move on.
No, no, carry on.
Any charity begins at home, you say.
I don't think we should give our money to this charity, for which we've probably received no recognition whatsoever. We also get crossed from the
charity. He's giving all about recognition.
No, but it would be nice to see, you know, get a letter of thank you or something, you know. And I don't think he will, and it's good.
I personally think it's a waste of £50.
Yeah, me too. Should be spent in Anston.
Cost to the parish council. Ask us
so we're able to subsidise the cost.
Well, you may have a point, but the mayor personally did not cut our budget.
She did.
Yeah, we had a hand in it.
Forget your personal feelings. The mayor personally did not cut our budget.
I don't think you know that, Colin.
And the mayor has a charity, and I think it's worthwhile. If you don't agree, vote against it. I'm not going to lose any sleep over it.
Can I just say that, you know, I mean, we're fighting tooth and nail trying to get cuts to the budget, cut back on hanging baskets, go to the front, then we're going to get £500 of it, the rest of it. And I just talked to somebody, sorry, Tom.
50. With all due respect, again, you're not making the distinction between the council and the mayor. It is the mayor's charity.
Well, it's not the mayor.
The mayor did not authorise the cuts. Now, if you don't agree, vote against it.
Maybe we should refer it to the council.
I think we all have our views on this, and I don't think discussing it further is going to it is going to help. Do you mind if we proceed to a vote on the proposal?
Right. Yeah.
Can I just say that next year we should put it to the council?
You put
£50
in our bucket, Miles, and Anston there.
Could we ask the public? Sorry,
Sandra.
I know.
I'll propose that before report.
Yes.
What are we voting for?
We're voting. So Colin's proposal is that we give £50 to the Mayor's charity.
Right.
All those in favour of giving £50 to the Mayor's charity?
I'm on my own again.
All those against?
I hate you, but
well, you tried, Colin. We'll tell the Mayor you tried.
Yes. Tell the Mayor you tried. The next item. Bradford Meadow. So, Colin, this is your item for Bradford Meadow.
Yes, thank you. For the benefit of new members, for the benefit of people who don't know, in 2013, Anston Parish Council bought what is now Bradford Meadows for £254,000. Now, I sat through every public meeting, and the word consultation was used, but I was never consulted. I've discussed this with councillor Mason. The residents of Bradford Road were never consulted, and the majority of the parish councils were never consulted. They're the residents. But that's by the by. The other part is that, unbeknown to everyone else, when this land was purchased, there's a covenant on it. And until 14th of August 2033, this council cannot sell the land the only person to come out of this was Mr. Cabell, who got a nice big chunk to his pension pot. This was a done deal that represents very, very poor value to the residents of Anston. And further to that, we can't pay the loan off early without a penalty. We could pay a sizeable chunk of it, but we can't pay it off. If we do, we have to pay a penalty. So here we have a situation where land was purchased that is greenbelt land. It's not in the local development plan. It's never going to be built on. The previous council, when they were tackling about this, then come up with some airy-fairy scheme. Oh, it was to enhance the woods, which is a load of rubbish, because the woods is a triple SLA site and it is already enhanced. So we now have a liability, because it's not a building debtor, because it isn't paid for. We have a liability for a piece of land to the value of £254,000 until August 2033 that we cannot dispose of. We cannot sell shares in it. The only thing we can do, and I remember we discussed this in council,
Colin, can Michael give a clarification?
Yeah, the only thing we can do as a council is to try and use this asset to raise revenue. That's all we can do with it. We have in effect, as a parish, paid 254,000 quid for two public rights of way. Because that's all it is.
Can we bring in Michael just to comment on
that? Yeah, I think just some slight clarification. The sum paid was, I believe, 107,000. The figure you're quoting is the 20 years worth of interest added on top of that. One of the reasons, all right, that's as well, it's a triple SI, but judging by the amount of dog fouling on Bradford Meadow, the reason that was bought was so the dogs could go up there, so they wouldn't go against the stones. That was the buffer. That's what was meant by protecting the woods.
In terms of selling
the land, there's nothing you can't. It's not that you can't sell the land. It's just that if it's sold for certain things, such as house building, then a proportion of the money would have to be paid to the previous owner. So it's only a covenant in terms of the council making a huge profit on that land by selling it for certain types of things. If it was sold for community use to somebody else, that covenant wouldn't click in. So there are certain things that you need to be aware of.
Yes, but to take your point about that dog fouling, there are two public rights of way across that land, and whoever owns it could not block off the public rights of way, so the same problem would arise.
No, it wouldn't, because if that land was sold for agriculture, or for putting horses on or whatever, then most of the fields would be blocked off. The public rights of way would be there, but there would then be a simple corridor straight into Anston Stowers Wood. So all that 32 acres of dog waste that's there would actually then be channeled down the public path straight into Triple SI side.
I mean, sorry, Jim, the only point I wanted to make is I think this was a
not so good deal. If you
would,
Mick had a point. I have a point, and then Stuart.
The only thing we're asking Stuart is that you've identified that it's a bit of a white elephant, to put it mildly. But we realise that, and we are doing all we can, not by getting people to use the field to hire it out, you know. We, like you said, we can't do anything else, really. So,
I just
wonder why you brought it up when we're already.
I just wanted to raise people's awareness that this wasn't the democratic deal it was made out to be.
Yeah, it wasn't. Well, I think we've got a bit of
a This council didn't buy Bradford Meadow, and I think although there are members of this council who might have bought Bradford Meadow, we just can't. I think the majority of people here tonight wouldn't have voted to buy Bradford Meadow, and we can't undo that. I'm not sure if this added anything to that debate. Other than we know that we most probably wouldn't have bought Bradford Meadow, but we didn't buy it the previous council as well, so you're quite right that actually what we need to do now is raise revenue.
Even as a minimum, I can't see us generating £12,800 a year, which covers the repayment cost.
Stuart?
Paul? Yeah, just a quick one. I mean, I'm not going against what the clerk just said, but from my memory, the argument about the dog feces, etc., the people that say, I think that, if I remember rightly, that item was put after the vote was taken. I could be wrong. But even now, we have a large amount of, she said, dog feces in the Triple SI site anyway, because people walk straight through the field into the area. Can I, obviously, I just left the room for a couple of minutes. Did you say about that we can, if we wish to, or we was of a mind to, we could sell Bradford, but obviously, with the caveat, if it was for building, we'd have to pay money, which I don't think you'd get money. So, at a future day, if we wished as a council, there is an option for discussion, and if there's a buyer, that's an option we could look at or discuss in the future if council is so desired.
But what would you do with the money? You can't pay the loan off early without a penalty.
Well, I'm quite sure if we got to the point where we're having discussions about doing that sort of thing, we could then approach the Public Loans Work Board and we would ask what the penalties are, etc. And then we'd make a financial decision whether it was in the interest of the parish or not. They may come back and say you've got paid in full. They may come back and say, right, we'll accept the loan, unless whatever. That's obviously then something we'd have to be there for a future date if council's desired.
Oh.
Mine was a bit tongue in cheek. I was going to say, people are just taking the doggies on there, charge them £1 for unlimited fouling for a week.
You can be the gate man, Paul.
It's a serious issue because it's something we may have to look at, not charging, but something we have to look at. Because if we're going to allow other events to happen in the field, if for instance I'm quite sure that the Volkswagen Club, if they wish to take it on, I'm quite sure some of them are wanting to pitch tents. And then it becomes a problem if there's dog feces everywhere. So it may be something we need to look at, and possibly restricting where dogs can go on that field.
This came up at the meeting that you were away from, Stuart, when Becky came to see us about the VW Club, and this is part of their preparation for the field. That they clean the field. And she says they're used to it, it happens on all the fields they've used, so I don't think it would be a problem.
Okay, ladies and gents, we do need to go into... Oh, I've got to come back to you, Mick.
Colin's point. If I'm not mistaken, there was publicity about it in the parish newsletter a few months ago. Well, 6 months ago. So I think people are aware that it wasn't us that actually made the decision to buy that. I'm sure people are aware.
Democratic.
We do need to allow time to go into the public session shortly, but can I ask if members would be willing to suspend standing orders for 10 or 15 minutes to allow us to get through some of this before going into the public session? It just means
I propose that
we're preempting the half past cut off to give us more time to go through this part of the agenda.
Well, I just wonder why I'm puzzled to why we're changing it.
Because at this moment in time, we'd now be suspending, we'd be finishing the agenda, we'd be allowing the public participation, we'd be doing the rest of the thing, and then possibly at 9:30 we might extend it once everybody's gone in.
Well, at 9:30 it's supposed to do with the charity, you know?
Yeah,
so, well, one of the proposals at 9:30. We'll get to 9:30.
So I propose suspending standing orders later on.
Is this for the public session? Is that we suspend the standing orders for public session?
We need to. What I want to do is we would normally go. Actually, we would have normally gone into the public session a few minutes ago. So what I would like to do is just to anticipate us getting to 9:30. So I would like to carry on, get through some of the end of agenda items now for the next 10 minutes. Just bearing in mind that we might need to stay after that to finish up a couple of items on the agenda.
Do you mean no public session, Drew?
No, we'll have a public session.
Well, can't you do it now so they can go home?
The session starts at 9:20.
Yes.
For 10 minutes.
Are we happy to go into the public session?
Another 5 minutes.
I think you should ask the public if they're willing to stay.
Public, would you mind going into a public session at 9:20 to allow us to do a couple more agenda items? Any objections? Thank you. Okay, let's keep going through the agenda items then. So, Bradford Meadow, come on, please. Consider whether to allow members access to the YLCA members section on its website.
Can I propose that we allow members access to the YLCA members section on the website? For those that don't know, YALC have got their own website. I can't remember what's on the front, but there's a council section only. And to get into the council section only, you have to have a password. But council, because it's YALC's webpage, they decreed that if councillors wish to go into the councillors section, they have to have a password, and the password has to have giving out of the password has to have authorisation of the council. So can I propose that the council allow members access to the members section?
I'll second that.
There are no cost implications.
No.
All those in favour? Councillor Sutherland to discuss publicity regarding RMBC cuts to parish council funding.
Right, well, I think we've gone over some of that. I'll try and keep it short. But I do think this council in particular does nothing regarding publicity. And I think that we should make some effort to write to the press and inform the public in general that that Rotherham Borough Council is withholding funding that they are in fact receiving from the government but won't give it to us. And just to publicise more the finances of the council.
Do you have a specific proposal, Chris?
Well, this is going to be another letter then, Michael. Are you up for that? With your expertise in being polite. it's basically about the money that RMBC are withholding. And I think generally members of the public don't know. I think we should write to the press, to all the papers, and it should be on the council website when the parish magazine goes electronic. Go on, Stuart.
Shall we take Stuart and then Colin and then Miles?
I agree what you're saying, in principle. I agree what you're saying. How do we write to Rotherham? Would you write to the letters page or would you get them to do an article?
A press release.
But if you do a press release, it's not guaranteed that they will put it in.
No.
I'm just trying to work out
There's never any guarantee with the papers, is there? You know, if something juicy comes up, then you're kept into touch. But at least we can try, and it can go on to the website when Drew sets it up.
I agree that we should maybe put something in the next newsletter.
Well, it would be better if we wait till it's electronic, Stuart, because I'm of the firm belief that people don't read the paper one. Well, I think they chuck it in the bag.
We haven't made the decision to go electronic yet.
No, but we nearly have, haven't we?
I will suggest, before we make a decision to go electronic, we'd have to have one copy as a final hardcore copy, hardback copy, to announce we go electronic before we go electronic, if that's what we decide.
Yes, yes. So, yeah.
Could I suggest that?
Well, we'll put it in the newsletter.
In the next newsletter.
Yeah.
Okay, Colin.
And write to the papers.
All I was going to do to back up Chris's suggestion was that the letter would make sure it's signed by the chairman.
Well, they're only signed by the clerk on behalf of the council.
Yes, but my own feeling is that the chairman should sign it as well.
We've got the council AGM coming up soon as well. That might be a good place.
Yeah, good time to bring that.
So
it would, yeah.
And
yeah.
Again, the more special people who care.
Anyway. But in general, this council does nothing to publicise anything.
Can I just make another suggestion? Shortly we'll be having the parish meeting, which is the one...
Miles just said that.
Is that the one you're on about? The parish meeting or the AGM? Right, that's the parish meeting. If you write to the clerk, get on the agenda, you can have a discussion at that parish meeting.
Oh, okay. Yeah, we'll do that then.
We'll do that parish meeting on the 21st of April. The parish and where we all can go.
Is that April? The annual meeting? 11th, is it?
So to get the in for the agenda.
Right, I'll do it tomorrow. No, the day after. What was the other thing I've got to say about?
Okay, any further comments on that one?
Strange.
What, Dylan?
Actually, Christine, did you amend your proposal? Did you decide to propose anything in the end?
Yeah, I'd want to propose that we include on the next newsletter information regarding RNBC cuts to Anston Parish Council, and to write to the Guardian, the Advertiser, the Sheffield Star, the Financial Times. Anybody else?
Curiosity, before we go on this, can I ask how far we are with the parish council having a social media site?
Not very far at all.
Okay, because I know Dillington's is still going strong.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'll get on with it.
Because again, that's good.
Yeah, come again, so, if we send a letter then to the Advertiser, the Guardian, do we really need to go to the Star?
Yes, because that's Sheffield.
Sheffield.
Oh, no, there's been plenty of stuff about us in the Star, Stuart.
Do we have a second for Christine's proposal? Oh, they are not. And a third from us. So, Christine, are you going to write a draft article, bring that before the Council?
Will you do it, Michael?
I don't really know what you're trying to achieve, so therefore you might as well write it.
Well,
the council would have to approve it because
that's the problem, you see.
The legal implications about.
If I send you some bullet points, will you do the letter? And then it won't have to come back to council. Can we do that?
I think it's best if you have a read before it gets gone, so we all agree.
Yeah, but it's going to come back, then it just goes on and on and on, Miles. Can we not agree to write?
How about if you propose to write something, put some bullet points down, send those to Michael. Michael agrees to put those in the newsletter, and then we bring a press release back to council. So something that in the newsletter disseminated locally, so we can approve that this evening. But then we say anything that's going to go into the press should come back to council, just to make sure that all councillors are happy with that.
I think majority. Anything that goes into any sort of print needs to come back here first.
Okay.
I think some of the things that you'll be implying may or may not be factual correct.
Right.
I don't know what the legal ramifications of various things are. So I think it's better off for the council to put, if he wants to, if the council wants to risk whatever it's going to risk by saying what it's going to say, then it needs to hold in mind that that's what it's going to do.
But in the meantime, in the next newsletter, Michael could simply acknowledge that there are restrictions on that.
I would get the council to approve where it's going to. But plenty of time for the next newsletter.
All right, if it's in print, yeah. When's the next newsletter, Michael?
June.
So we might scrape it through.
Exactly.
Or we might not.
If we can move through items on the agenda quickly.
The proposal is to include the next newsletter.
Well, I think we're
going to CS to supply bullet points and for approval at the next council.
All those in favour? All those against?
Okay, we're now out of time, so can we go into public participation?
Yes.
Any questions for me? Whenever you're ready.
Right, I've been in Kevin, is it Roach,
ma'am?
He came knocking at our door delivering red leaflets last week from Rotherham, and he said, "What had I any questions and what was going on?" And I said, "How long have you got?" But anyway, what I did say to him was about this skate park, and he said, "Was I aware that there was some money to go to the area assembly, as there was this money?" And he said, "To have a word with the chairman." I rang Miles up and told Miles about it. So are we having a representation or something from here to the area assembly? If there's some money available, like you were saying, so we can get some for the skate park.
Okay, Sandra, can I just clarify that? Because
yeah.
that was a question
yes.
that you wanted to put to the council.
Yes.
Could you raise that at the start of the council meeting? So the purpose of this session here is for members of the public to comment on the proceedings that have
gone on
actually taken place this evening. Whereas that was a question about the skate park, which wasn't discussed during the meeting. But if you would like to liaise with Councillor Manchin.
Just a quick point, Senator. Just a quick point, Senator. The money, the area, I don't know what the money is, what the area assembly's got, but I'm led to believe it's not very much.
Well, whatever it is, Stuart, it's something, isn't it? We know it's not a lot, but them lads out there keep saying, how much have we got?
Yeah,
and it's an incentive for them.
Yeah, what I'm saying is, I don't know how much it is, but it's not a big sum. What I'm going to say to you is, you need to approach the area assembly direct, because we don't really have that much to do with the area assembly. If you speak to, I think it's Andrew Mason.
It's quite a simple question. How many committees have we actually got? And has any of these committees ever taken made any decisions, or haven't even had any a full meeting? You've been in office over 12 months now, going up towards 12 months, and there's not been that much progress on any of these meetings, really.
Until this evening, the only committee in existence was the staffing committee.
But these groups have been formed?
No. We discussed forming them. But the only committee that was actually formed and complete in terms of staffing, staffing and open spaces. So staffing and open spaces, my apologies, are the only two committees that are actually established, and the only two committees that are, the staffing committee has obviously met and met regularly. Open spaces committee, has that met? Has met once.
And no reports have come back to council from open spaces.
It did lose over last year.
Can I just come in to be helpful? Just to be helpful, what actually happened is, at the beginning of the year, we had working groups in progress that, I can't remember now, one or two of them met, began forming policy, and then it was suggested at a council meeting that these working groups were secret. And we had a lot of members of the public talking about the council meeting in secrecy. As a result of that, when we had training with YARC, we brought the subject up with the trainer, and it was suggested at that training that we convert to committees. So we had a long period where, for various reasons, we converted into committees, and as a result of that, we're changing from working groups into committees, we've had a delay in what we've done.
In a way,
it's a home goal, because you've complained about secrecy. We,
a proper politician,
we changed as a council to accommodate or take the views of the public, and the result of that has been a delay. So,
no, rubbish. The truth of the matter is...
It's rubbish, but you suggested we would meet...
Yeah, we did.
There was one question and one answer.
Well, am I not allowed to reply to it? The thing is, the only question I've asked you tonight is you formed these. You didn't do it for benefit of the public, you did it because your council told you you're open and transparent, which is what it should be.
Well, they didn't tell us, we made the decision.
Yeah, they made the decision, they did you the suggestion. Now, what I'm saying to you is, you've been in office now for over 12 months. You've got coming up for 12 months. And you've got two committees. How many have you tried to form?
Well, you scuppered
there's
it.
There's no progress.
But well, you scuppered it.
I just told the reason why.
I scuppered it.
You did.
You're pretty right.
When you set a new
issue. But you did scupper it.
Tonight, you've changed it from 6 to 14. I suggested.
We'd had to.
I changed it. I had suggested in a council meeting some months ago that I thought that it was unfair that a working group or whatever should have more members, because if it came back to the council, it was already the majority, could make a decision and then bring it back to a council for a vote. You've overturned that tonight. So as far as I'm concerned, you've still got back to secrecy.
We've had to, because there were too many people wanted to be on the committee. We brought the number down at your suggestion.
You know what we're having.
I did.
That's why. Well, yes, you didn't know
your
class
had been
appointed.
That's got nothing to do with the subject.
We didn't
either. It's got nothing to do with it.
I'll just leave it with you.
It's the formation of the committees.
No, it didn't. But the answer was just, you know, how many committees were formed, how many committees has actually met, and what's happened. That's all. So I ask you.
Next question.
Yeah, as regards these cuts that you've got from Rotherham that you all keep harping on about, but nobody's yet given us an answer on how you're going to make any savings to the amount of money for the cuts that you've had. I asked a question the other week whether or not Anston Parish Council could continue with two borough councillors rather than three, which would save us £12,000 a year. I'm wondering whether or not you've got an answer for me yet.
What's the goals?
Because that's
a question for borough.
We don't pay them.
We can't answer that because now we see.
No, but if you went to RMDC and said, rather than paying £36,000 for councillors, leave us as £10,000. Until you ask the question, you'll never know.
Public have a right to go and ask the question.
I ask my councillors to do it because I elected you to speak on my behalf.
Your councillors are elected to represent you and other members of the public at parish council level and parish council issues. We individually go to what...
I asked borough councillor to go and ask that.
Who did you ask?
The borough councillor.
Wait,
the council.
Have you asked the borough? Have you asked the borough?
No notice at all what I said.
Have you asked the borough councillor?
I asked the committee and the chairman to go, and he said, but who would I ask? And I said, well, look, if it has to be that far, ask our MP to actually take it to Parliament and ask Parliament whether there's any law or legislation that we have to have three.
Have you tried doing this, Kevin?
Why do you want to move on, Stuart? Is it too difficult question you've been to ask?
Mr. Campbell, we've answered your question.
You haven't answered me.
All right, I'll answer the question again then. The issue you raise about two borough councils instead of three is an RMDC issue. And if you wish to raise that, you have to raise it as an individual. So parish councillors on this table are here to represent the public at parish council level and at parish council issues. If you wish to approach your three RMDC councillors, that's up to you.
Can you also tell me where expenses are paid from then?
Ladies
and gents, and can I remind you again that the purpose of this section of the meeting is to raise issues that relate to this particular meeting. These are questions that have been asked previously, or that should be asked at the start of the meeting. So this is an opportunity for members of the public to comment on what we've been discussing today. I'm sure there are plenty of things that you might like to comment on about the meeting today.
You discussed budget as well, didn't you?
If you do have any further questions for Clive as the borough councillor, then I suggest that you ask Clive. If he was to speak to
Just to answer that question, and that means that you have got no authority upon but to speak on my behalf. So I would have wasted time actually coming and voting for a parish council. I can't come and ask you a question to ask either you to go and ask Clive or to ask Robert. You're telling me that that's just a waste of time.
No, you must go to Clive.
Exclude the press and the public to discuss items, whatever they are, 19, is it?
19 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
So in effect, what I'm proposing is, we extend the time for 15 minutes.
And 12, too.
We exclude the press and the public so we can go into the confidential session.
We suspend
the council meeting now to go into the charity meeting, and then go back into the council meeting. So what I'm saying is that if we go into the council meeting now, the public right thinking can stay for that.
No further questions, but any further questions from the public? Apologies for absence. The same councillors as noted in the council meeting. Any items anyone wanted to declare any interest in any of the matters to be considered?
Did you turn that off? Mm.
It's
not confidential. It's the charity.
A charity meeting after a council meeting?
Because I need to get a check approved.
Right. I understand you need to get a check approved, but we've never done this before.
Yeah.
And what springs to mind is you're doing this because we've voted down the charity check selling committee.
Yes,
it's quite possibly what I find that in bad taste because We've never done this before, so why now? Because it needs sidewalk. It's as simple as that. Right. So, is the gas bill the same?
Yes.
Why does the gas bill have to be signed so urgently?
It's paid by the 4th of April, we've got it to be in the April, in 2 weeks and days, we just need sidewalk.
If we don't approve this thing tonight, what would the consequences be? Can I propose that we authorise a cheque to be signed on the payments? Well, I'm trying to be helpful. The point I'm making is, I think we're sat here now as a direct result of not having us voted down that cheque committee, and I'm not impressed. So, can I propose, what do I need to propose? That we authorise payments. I'd like to propose that we authorise the payment.
Can we have a second? Chris. All those in favour? Date and time for the next meeting, on Wednesday the 13th of April, 7 p.m. So we'll reopen the council meeting.
Can we do the turn lockdown first?
Sorry, what were you
going to
say?
Good allotments. Oh, sorry.
Colin.
Yeah, can I propose that items 12, 18, 21, 22, 23 are deferred because the relevant people aren't here?
We've gone past that.
Sorry, Colin, we've gone past that. We're on.
We haven't discussed it.
We haven't had time. We've run out of time, we're in a confidential session to discuss the issues.
We're in a confidential session, then, the public here.
We're just going to vote to exclude.
Item 18. anyone like to propose? So we'll resolve to exclude the press and the public due to the confidential nature of the business to be transacted. Do I have a second then?
Yeah.
Let's go with the wall. All those in favour? Thank you. So, could I ask the press and public to leave? Thank you very much.
5 minutes, Ben.
Good night, Dad. Cool.
Hey?
Thank you.
Good night, Brian.
Good night, Brian.
Good night, Brian.
Christine.